Let us understand the experiment by which we can observe a single slit diffraction pattern on a screen. Again, here in the picture you can see an enlarged view of a thin slit, which is having a slit width B on which a parallel light is allowed to incident, which is having an intensity I naught. And due to all these wavelets, 1, 2, 3 up to n, light waves are emitted in all directions, and here we are considering light waves which are going in a direction at an angle theta from the direction of incident light. In this situation, we have studied that the far away distance from the slit, when these parallel waves will superpose at a point, the resulting intensity is given as I naught sin square beta by beta square. Now, if we place a lens over here, there's a convex lens having focal length f, and exactly at a distance f from the lens, so we place a screen. Now, in this situation here, we can see when parallel light rays will incident onto the lens, without introducing any path difference, the lens will converge all these parallel rays onto a point which will lie in the focal plane of the lens. So, if this is the point, the light ray which is passing through the optic center of the lens will be going as it is, and this is the point where the light rays are going to converge. So, when all light rays will incident onto it, these are going to converge at this point, which I'm trying to draw, as this is the point which is in the focal plane of the lens, and these all light rays are going to converge at this point, and will superpose and produce the same intensity which will be produced when these light rays would be meeting at infinite position or distance from the slit in absence of the lens. So, this is the point P where I can write intensity at point P on a screen. If this is a screen, this will be given as I naught sin square beta by beta square, where we can write the value of beta is pi b sin theta by lambda. And at the central point, intensity is I naught. We already discussed this, the central maxima. And on the central maxima, the two sides, where our first minimum is produced, upper one as well as the lower one, between the two, this is the width of central maxima, and we have discussed that from the direction of theta is equals to 0 on the two sides, first minima would be located at an angle theta 1 and theta 1. And at this angle theta 1, we have seen in the previous section, it is given as sine inverse of lambda by b. And in this situation, if b is a small, lambda by b value is a small, here we can write sine inverse lambda y to be equals to lambda y b, because sine theta 1 is approximately theta 1. So, the value of theta 1 can be approximated as lambda y b. So, in this situation, this width of central maxima, if it is w, we can directly write here the width of central maxima is this w, we can write as angular width is 2 theta 1 and this distance is f. So, here we can write w is equals to 2 theta 1 multiplied by f. So, this will be 2f lambda by b. This is the width of central maxima on the screen placed at a distance equal to the focal length of lens, and lens is considered to be very close to the slit. Now, in this situation at theta equal to 0 on the screen, there will be a bright fringe which is called central maxima. Then there will be dark fringes on the either side of it. And correspondingly at various angles, which we have studied, the angular positions of different minima, if we calculate, we already discussed that a minima is a position where b sin theta is equals to m lambda, because we have taken the value of beta was m pi. This implies the value of theta minimum. Wherever a minimum or a dark fringe is produced, this corresponding to a dark fringe, the value of theta minimum is given as sin inverse of m lambda by b. This is the angle where or angular position from central maxima wherever a minima is produced. And between all minima, there are maxima. So that will be the bright fringes on the two sides, upper and lower side of the central maxima.